Hi, we're out here. You can't see us because it's night, and we're out here testing the LED for the ROV, and this is what it looks like. And we're happy with that. That building down there.
80 feet.
Yeah, it'd be about 75-80 feet. Yeah,
so here's the constant current power supply we're using. Chinese bought, I don't remember, I think it's $85 for the power supply and the LED. And this LED is probably not the first run, it's probably a second or third run. So there's not going to be really 10,000 lumens, but you know, there's an array of LEDs down in there. And we made the cone. It's just a piece of aluminum pipe turned, and it has a 3-degree taper on the side. We might experiment with something with a bigger taper on it, so they make a little bit more of a spotlight, but we're actually kind of pleased with the results there. And then we're going to mount it up in the housing, and we're just going to do that on some of the stiff wiring so that we can just bend it to point the direction we want each of them to point to. Next is we're going to pot these in silicone in a vacuum to try and seal up those LEDs a little better, but we've already pressure tested them, and we know that they're going to hold at least for a while at depth. Now, the camera's going to adjust its lighting, but comparing, contrasting the two, it'll work just fine.
You can still see it, it's fine.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you had 9,000 lumens, but it doesn't, unfocused is just ridiculous. And that really doesn't do anything.
Didn't make any difference, you just cutting
the light.
You're
blocking that light on the edge.
Yeah.
Alright, so that's the cone. Andrew loaned me a couple of his reflectors. He's building LED flashlights, really, really powerful ones. And this one did pretty good, and it's not too big that it wouldn't fit inside the housing. I need four of them in there, but he's taken an idea that we want to go with something that's more like a flashlight. And with one LED, you can have a much more focused beam. And you know, something that has a spotlight that can be adjusted to, because then you could bring it up to the surface, you know, and adjust it for the mission that you're going to send it on. If you want something broad, then you're going to be close to it, and you want something broad. If you want something that's a long way away, you might want a pinpoint light. They're just more flexibility. Yeah, that came out pretty good. This is cutting with a 1/16-inch ball nose end mill, and I got it stepping over just 2/1000ths of an inch, so those are pretty smooth. I'm trying to cut back on how much polishing I'm going to have to do. Didn't come out bad for not being polished or anything yet. A flame polishing would get a little bit of it done, but not much. Yeah, I've tried it on another one. If I get it on there too close, if for some reason the heat picks up on those little bumps more than it does down on the flat. So see, it does pretty good on the bumps, but getting the flat down in there is going to be a matter of hand polishing it. Getting in a Chinese factory.
Usually Chinese kids don't really stop.
They never stop working.
Sometimes they stop.
Nope, never.
Really? Really?
Really. They work day and night like that.
Oh, they know.
It's true.
Oh. You suffered from a morbid fear of starving to death.
So she came out pretty good.
Oh, that one it made.
Blew it out.
Look at it.
Yeah, sure, you can look at it.
Will it blind me?
No, it won't blind you. Is it on?
No.
A little closer. Is it on?
That one got me.
see the light. I've seen the light. Like, that should be focusing the light for us.
I think that's enough light.
Yeah, it is. It's working.
That's enough light.
But we gotta try it in the water.
Are you scared of the dark, little boy?
No.
No. See, red to red, black to black. Ready? Boom! Boom! That's a lot of light. Okay, let's turn it off here.
All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, power up. All right, that's no lens. And that's with a lens. And I think, yeah, that helps. See, there's a more focused light in the center. Now, no lens, and see, it doesn't have that. I move the light around, you don't even see anything changing. Now, you just see the shadows changing. So I put the lens back on. And, yeah, see, now you can actually see it is poking more light in. All right, turn it off. Off. It's getting too hot. It's melting down. All right, very good.
On the lens, there was more light in the center.
In the center, that's right. That's what we wanted, more light in the center. Okay, let's try it underwater now, because that's going to change it.
Okay, out of the water, on. Ooh, look at that, bright. And in the water. Oh, nice.
And it works in salt water.
Yeah, look at that. Look at the changes the refraction, though. You can actually see the little bumps of the lights on it. Yeah. I'm not sure what it's going to look like at a distance, but it'll be fine.
It looks like it's running away.
Oh, look, you can actually see the little squares of the light.
Oh, me too.
And there's without the filter.
You see the lights.
See, you put this on.
Now you see the lights again.
Now you see the actual little squares of the...
Dang.
Yeah. Yeah, that's cool.
That is.
It's cool.
Yeah.
Oh, look at look. Do you see the hydrogen coming off the light?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
That white stuff?
Yeah, I'm talking about that.
That's because we're putting voltage into the water, and it's salt water.
And water, I hope it works.
Turn it off! Turn it off!
Stop!
What?
Between them and my eyes.
Oh, look at that. It's still glowing even after it's turned off.
Can I see?
It's stopped.
Oh, dang it. Can we try again?
Yeah, go ahead. Turn it on a little bit. Now off. Yeah, see, look at them. They're still glowing a little bit. That might be salt water. We're going to have to insulate those a little bit, see if we can stop it from doing that. That may not be good for it.
It did good in salt water.
I'm very happy with it.
Sweetie.
We're draining our vacuum off here.
Yes, Australia. That's Sydney Harbor. We can sail down to Australia.
This is a spray-on chrome, and it's not bad. So take a look at that. That's not bad. Kind of shiny. And it's the product is Eastwood's liquid chrome. You let it dry for 20 minutes, you buff it with a soft cloth, and then you let it dry for 12 to 24 hours, and you're ready for the clear coat that goes on next. Well, I actually think they were shinier before the clear coat went on, but we'll try a different clear coat. I don't think that thin stuff has much durability anyway. We're gonna try this on it instead. Now I tested the two LEDs that Lyle potted for me, and they work fine, so I'm just doing the other two. Yeah, see the bubbles coming out from underneath those things? That's what we're after, is get all that air out of there. See, once the bubble rises to the surface and pops, then all it can do when it takes the vacuum off is the goo goes underneath. There may also be some bubbles underneath still, but they'll compress so small that they won't matter. The idea here is those little LED elements are just soldered onto this board. So if we don't pot them and separate them from the seawater, then they become like a little oxygen generator or an HHO generator. Wow, that one over there is really bubbling up. Andrew Harmon's the guy that recommended this goop. It's like a silicone, but it's RTV here, 118, translucent adhesive. And the thing about it is it's real thin. It flows really easy. You wouldn't get normal silicone to do this. Now let's have a little fun here. I shut off the vacuum pump, and I'm going to release the vacuum. Look at those bubbles go down. Yeah, that should have popped them. We're going to close that back up. Turn it back on. See if they haven't just as big.
Yeah, a little bit less bubble action this time, so that'll help.
There we go.
Now the deal is just clean it off the lenses by rubbing across them to make it a thin layer on the LEDs. Even though it dries translucent, you know, we don't want a lot of it on there.
Okay, there's our light. You can see how it's focused now some. This has the reflector shield on it.
Water. Here.
You may need to do some adjustment on it, but I kind of like that. I don't see the little squares. Well, I kind of can. But it's all a matter of how far you place the lens from the LEDs themselves. Let me try it without the shield on it here. See, it's a lot broader, and you can start seeing some of those LED reflections there. With it on, you don't get them. And it definitely is a more constrained cone of light, and I like that.
And there's no longer any bubbles coming up from it. So you get out to the lake, that's about as good as we're going to do for here for testing. Let's see what that cone is at distance.